Going into this expansion, we really wanted to use the opportunity to advance some of the storylines that are in New Eden. Obviously, New Eden has been around for 20 years, and there are multiple factions, multiple stories. Some have progressed, some have like stayed stagnant for a while. The Jovian are one of those holy grails that we haven't touched really for almost 20 years. And we really wanted to sort of pick up that storyline again and reveal a little bit more. So when we were thinking about coming up with a pirate hideout, if you will, we sort of decided that it would be a very cool idea to make this first revelation, Jove revelation, and be tied with that opportunity as well. So we came up with Sarsak, which is sort of a hub, an ancient Jovian transport hub. It has Jovian relics, Jovian station, and it provides a very cool background for the pirates and also provides us with a very cool starting point in continuing with the Jove story.
Our main goals when looking at Sarsak was to create something visually stunning, but also something not seen before. Eve usually quite dark, so we wanted to contrast that now with something different. My main part in when working in a project like this is working with all the artists on the idea stage, but then giving artists as much autonomy as possible to run with their ideas. And then it's more just about kind of nudging it in the right direction. And then in the end, when all pieces kind of start to come together, it's a lot of tweaking, making things come together and fit nicely as a whole package. We also wanted to incorporate our new volumetric cloud technology into this space. Yeah, and create something visually stunning to explore.
We did a lot of effort to make it feel like a pirate then. And we wanted to really try to capture this pirate feel in Sarsak, while at the same time it's Jovian. It's the space is totally different. It has the atmosphere is totally different. It has these stat zones. It has this limited visibility. And a lot of it hasn't been discovered yet. It's very mysterious, but once you dock into the Fulcrum, you will see that you're inside this massive Jovian station and the pirates have really just occupied a small part of it.
The way that we approached the soundtrack of Sarsak is we wanted a chaotic Jovian darkness to it, which for the music is reminiscent of the structure in wormhole space music, but with its own Jovian sound palette. And we were aiming at the gray zone area between sound and music, so the music doesn't have themes or pulse or rhythm or even chord progressions. It's more of a flowing, always evolving texture that maintains a red thread in the Sarsak sound, but it's never repeating itself in exactly the same way. For the transition to the death zone, so coming from the safe zone and transitioning, flying out into the death zone, we wanted to do something special, something that introduces a sense of change, but which is not explicitly obvious. So we wanted it to feel like you enter into a different, very foreign world that is dangerous and harmful. And the way the music does this is that it filters out part of the safe zone music and introduces new layers that are hazardous in character. And it's made in a way that you're not supposed to really notice it. It merges with the sound design and it merges with the general feel of Sarsak. So I actually hope you don't notice it. But I also hope that you sense the feeling of Sarsak that it's a part of giving rise to as you are in that system.
The Deathless and the Deathless Circle is a bit of a mystery. It's clear that they arrived in Sarsak some time before anyone else did. And the understanding is that they moved in, managed to get basic understanding and control of the system through the Fulcrum, like operating the gates. It's the Deathless that controls the gates. He can open and close them. He basically controls the system. that Atlas has decided to invite the angels and the Charistus and used Sarsak as a pirate haven. What the Deathless gets out of it is access to resources, to materials, enable more features and functionality of Sarsak, if you will. How much more the Deathless knows about Sarsak, how many more locations he has discovered is, as of yet, unknown. But going forward with the Deathless, that is something that we really want to do, and we really want to do that in a in-game narrative way where you, the players, participate, and that is sort of what we have thought of with the Deathless and Sarsak in general, as a starting point for something more.
What I'm happiest with Sarsak is seeing the environment come together with all the Jove structures that have been built. It's a beautiful space to fly around and explore. Seeing the art team collaborate with other teams in a creative storm, everyone pitching in ideas. When we get to that kind of work environment, then the best results happen.
For the past few days and leading up to the expansion, you will be able to assist the pirates in preparing for their insurgencies. They are asking you to go out there into the Drifter Hives, collecting materials, bring it back to Sarsak, and they are using those materials to get the Fulcrum more operational and building the Shipcaster. You, the player, are of course rewarded by the pirates by getting early access to the destroyers. At the expansions, the insurgencies will start, but also every once in a while something will happen in Sarsak itself where you will be able to assist the pirates or not in achieving their goals, in bringing the Fulcrum to its full potential, in discovering things and going further.